And the first thing that you need to know is the difference between this and the free version, which you can download on renewedvision.com right here. The difference is the free version has a presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter show. On today's show, what you need to buy if you're starting completely from scratch with ProPresenter. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you're brand new to ProPresenter, first off, watch until the end because I've got a quick start course I'm going to offer you for free. So make sure you get that. But secondly, you might be confused about what you need to get started. So like, subscribe, etc., and you can get notifications when I release one of these tutorials, which I do every Tuesday. With that said, getting started with ProPresenter, it can be a little confusing. And so I'm not going to talk about the UI and where everything is located. I just want to talk about maybe what you should buy in order to get going. So let's head over to my computer and we'll get started. So this is ProPresenter, and the first thing that you need to know is the difference between this and the free version, which you can download on renewedvision.com right here. The difference is the free version has a watermark that it will show up from time to time. So if I go here and I'm going to real quick go to registration and deregister my ProPresenter here. So I'm not going to sign out really. I'm going to change it from active to inactive. Basically, it'll do the exact same thing, and that means pretty quickly, look, ProPresenter logo shows up here. So let me hide myself here real quick. Yep, so the ProPresenter logo shows up, and it also says see inactive right here. This is turned sideways, so that's why it's looking like that, but that's the first thing that you should know. So if we go back here and I set this back to active because I've already logged into my account and everything, then that immediately goes away. So that's important to know. One thing about that is, hit the right button. One thing about that is that you can use the free version that you just download without putting any information in. You can use that to create stuff on your home computer, on a computer in the office that's not used for presentation. You can go Mac to Windows, Windows to Mac, Mac to Mac, Windows to Windows, doesn't matter. As long as the fonts are the same in both machines and you've got them set up to display the same resolution, it should look virtually identical. You might have slight tweaks, but in general it should be virtually identical. So you can download the free version for use at home or on another computer. What you pay for is the ones that are actually presenting. So keep that in mind. So let's say you're using this for big church, then you would pay for one that would go to the screens in Big Church, right? Now, what if your youth ministry said, oh, well, we've got a youth program at exactly the same time and we want to use it too? Well, if that's the case, you'll need a second seat for them to use it at exactly the same time. About then, look at the numbers, but about then, the subscription price gets the same for the house of worship market. They don't offer this to government organizations or other secular organizations, just the house of worship market. It makes sense to get the campus license. So think of that campus license as probably more than you'll ever need. So if you need one, just get a single seat. If you need two, there is an argument to be made for just getting two individual seats, but I would probably go ahead and get the campus license so that in the future, when the children's ministry says, oh, us too, for our big group program, we want to use ProPresenter, then you're fine. If you add a second venue within the same church campus, then you're fine. You don't have to turn on and off stuff, make it active, inactive. So that's the first thing, is the license for ProPresenter, which you can get as part of a either monthly or yearly subscription now. So that's the first thing you need. The second thing that you may need, do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got a either a 1 or 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. Is if we go back here, and I go into ProPresenter and then Settings, it might be Preferences if you're on Windows or on an older Mac, Preferences, and then I go to Integrations. This is some other stuff that is optional, but is going to make your life easier. So, Planning Center Online. If you're familiar with Planning Center, what it does is it enables you to, depending on which plugins and all you get, you can schedule people to be at church, volunteers, staff people, etc. You can use it for practicing with your worship team or band or choir or whatever. You can also use it to create the plan, the list. Right here we have a playlist. Basically, you can create that in Planning Center, or you can create it in ProPresenter, upload it to Planning Center, and then on a different ProPresenter machine, download it. So that's something else that's helpful here. Multitracks and Song Select by CCLI, they do very similar things. There are some differences, and I just recorded a tutorial, which I think I'm going to release before I release the one that you're watching. So go back to a previous week to compare and contrast those two for importing lyrics. By the way, they're designed for importing lyrics that are still under copyright. If you're a traditional church and all the hymns that you do were created in 1924 or earlier, then, and that's as I'm recording this in 2024, then you'd be okay with using those because they're now in the public domain. Double check to make sure that I'm not incorrect about the years, but they should be in the public domain if they're 100 years old or so. So, then you don't need these. Resi is for live streaming, and it is a paid service. All of these are paid services, by the way. Resi is for live streaming, and it's a really robust live streaming solution, but it could be you're using another live streaming solution that you're paying for separately, or it could be that you're using a free service like YouTube or Facebook. And if that's the case, then you may not need Resi. So, if it were me, what would I get? I would probably get ProPresenter, at least one seat, and build on the free version, and then present on the one paid for seat, if that's all I need. Get more if you need more. Secondly, I would probably get either Song Select by CCLI so that I could search for the appropriate stuff and the worship and download those lyrics and everything. It makes it really, really easy to do. Plus, for displaying them, you do need a license of some sort. So the CCLI license would be a good choice. Or the multi-tracks license with its associated service where you can download lyrics. One of those two, they're slightly different. Again, refer back to the previous tutorial and take a look at that. So those are the things that I would say you probably absolutely need, unless, as I say, you're only doing hymns that are in the public domain, then don't worry about that at all. But do keep in mind, the second that you're displaying music that is still under copyright, you do need permission to do that. At least in the U.S., there's no exception for displaying that. Because when the exception in the law was written, everyone was using hymnals. So, hasn't been updated, even though maybe it should be. Okay, so that's kind of the basics of what you need. When it comes to computers, the hardware to display it, you will need a modern computer, more RAM is better, a better video card is better, and I don't think, hey, I'll just have my nephew who just built a gaming machine build your ProPresenter computer, because some things that are better for gaming are not as good for ProPresenter. There are certain video cards that ProPresenter doesn't like. So do some research if you're going the Windows route. If you're going the Macintosh route, make sure you have enough outputs on your computer. The regular M1, M2, M3 chip only can display two outputs, and if it's a laptop, one of those is built in. So that's a downside. But if you go with an M1 Pro, M2 Pro, etc., then it can do two additional outputs for a total of three. So just keep that in mind when you're shopping hardware-wise. More RAM is always better. A better video card is always better. You may think, oh, I don't need more than 256 gigs of storage. Yeah, you'll probably fill it up pretty quick. So I usually recommend trying to get a terabyte if you can. But anyway, all that to say, those are the things that you need when you're first getting started with ProPresenter, having not used it previously. If you liked this particular lesson, I think you absolutely ought to sign up for the ProPresenter Quick Start course. So go to tdm.fyi/proquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll register you for that class for free. And you can get your arms around the very basics of ProPresenter. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.